हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज रामजतन यादव। आई एम फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जिम्स इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज ग्रेटर नोएडा। हियर आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर ऑन द सब्जेक्ट ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग। इट इज़ माय नाइन्थ लेक्चर इन द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द लेक्चर एंड द टॉपिक इज एक्चुअली गोइंग ऑन, that is the suspension system. Today we will discuss about the air suspension system. Before it, I would like to tell about what we were discussing in the previous chapter, that is the suspension system. Also we will discuss about the introduction about the suspension system, types of suspension system, and your component that are used in your suspension system, function and requirement of the suspension systems, different types of the spring which are used, torsion bars. These things are we already discussed in previous chapters. Okay, your one topic is your suspension system. Okay, as you know that the suspension is the term given to the system of springs, of absorber and linkages that connect a vehicle to its wheel. Okay, as you also know that it serves a dual purpose, that is the contributing of the car's handling and brakings, protect the vehicle itself and any cargo or luggage from the damage and wears. This is about your the suspension system. Now come at the actual topic, that is the air suspension system. What is the air suspension system and how it is worked? Nowadays it is very popular, means air suspension system is very popular nowadays. Why? Because it is compact and fit well in automobile. It is very compact, means the size of air suspension system is smaller as compared to the others. One thing more, in this system the leveling valves are used to control the riding qualities and maintain the car at a constant height regardless of the amount of load it is carrying. And the layout of this air suspension system is here. You see, here is the air spring, leaf valve, air actuator, compressor. Actually these are the components which are used in your air suspension system. Air filter is there, air from the atmosphere getting from the air filter. Now lift valve, lift control valve, and you see here the supply line, return line, leveling valve, air spring. This is your diagram. Okay, air suspension is a type of vehicle suspension power that is powered by an electric or engine driven air pump or compressor. Okay, here a compressor, air compressor, which actually compress the air. This compressor pump the air into the flexible bellow, usually made from the textile reinforcement rubber. Okay, this is in turn inflates the bellow and raises the chassis from the axle. See, in this system the four spring of conventional suspension system are replaced by four air स्प्रिंग यूनिट्स, सी एयर स्प्रिंग, एयर स्प्रिंग, एज यू सी एयर स्प्रिंग, एयर स्प्रिंग, देर आर फोर एयर स्प्रिंग्स, दीज फोर एयर स्प्रिंग्स रिप्लेसेस द कन्वेंशनल सस्पेंशन सिस्टम. ओके, ईच एयर स्प्रिंग हैव सम वर्क. व्हाट वॉज दैट? ईच एयर स्प्रिंग यूनिट कंसिस्ट जनरली ऑफ अ बैरल और डोम शेप. सी इट इज इन डोम शेप चैम्बर, डोम शेप एयर चैम्बर, इन टू विच रबर डायफ्राम और बिलो इज पोजिशन. ओके, द डायफ्राम इज कंप्रेस्ड बाई ए स्पेशली शेप्ड प्लंजर. दिस डायफ्राम इज प्रेस्ड बाई अ स्पेशली शेप प्लंजर, द लोअर एंड ऑफ द विच इज अटैच टू एन एक्सेल. द एयर चैम्बर इज फास्टेंड टू द फ्रेम ऑफ द कार, दस द प्लंजर पुशेस अगेंस्ट द डायफ्राम, दैट इज अटेम्प्टिंग टू कोलैप्स इट इन टू द एयर चैम्बर. ईच यूनिट इज फिल्ड विद द कंप्रेस्ड एयर विच सपोर्ट द वेट ऑफ द व्हीकल. Now come on the, what is the function of leveling valve? Leveling valve is to control the flow of air to and from the air spring units. See, leveling valve, it control the to and from their air spring. Flow of control, it actually control the flow of the air. Where at each of the four wheel, as required to maintain the level of the body parallel to and at a fixed distance from the ground. The leveling valve are attached to some portion of the vehicle frame, and each actually consists of two valves in one unit. The one valve allow air to enter the air domes, and other valve allow air to escape the lift valve and then to the atmosphere. Okay, now the compressed air is supplied by an air supply system. This is consists of an air compressor, an air tank, a pressure regulator and a solenoid valve. The air compressor takes the atmospheric air through a filter and compress it to a pressure of about 200 megapascal. And at this pressure, the air in the tank is maintained. See, the air compressor is driven by a belt from the crankshaft pulley. Okay. Now, what happened? The high pressure air is reduced to 120 megapascal by a pressure regulator valve. Air pressure regulator valve, which reduces the pressure of the air, and it is admitted into four air spring unit through leveling valves. Whenever there is insufficient air in airbag, that side of vehicle will ride low. This state will cause leveling arm to move through the linkage, thereby opening the valve and admitting more air. See, the purpose of solenoid valve is to supply the air springs with the regulated air pressure when it is required to correct additional loading of the vehicle or to raise the vehicle body above the normal heights. Since the regulated air pressure is greater than the exhaust pressure, the air flow from the air Sorry, the air that is the flow from the air spring through the return line is reversed, and the air enters the air springs, which raising the car height up. This is actually the total working of your air suspension system. See, this is all about your air suspension system. which is also given in this. As I told these things in this PPT, here you can see advantages of an air suspension system. These maintain a constant frequency of vibration whether the vehicle is laden or unladen. Constant frame height is maintained. It helps to reduce the load while the vehicle in motion. The dynamic loading, as the spring rate is variation between the laden and unladen weight, is much less. It gives a smooth and comfort ride of the vehicle. The stiffness of the system increases with increase of the deflection. What are the common air suspension problems? Airbag or air systems failure due to the old air or moisture within the air system that damages them from the insides. Compressor may also be fail. Dryer may also be fail. C. Primarily due to the leakage air spring or air struts. Compressor burnout may also be caused by the moisture from within the air system coming into the contact with its electronic parts. Dryer failures, which function to remove the moisture from the air system, eventually become the saturated and unable to perform that function. These are the common failure or common, or you can say that, disadvantage of air suspension systems. And no doubt the cost of this system is very high, and the compressing of air supply system is very complex, and greater maintenance is also required for this system. Thank you.